It's always an adventure buying parts for the Acty. Some parts are sold purpose-made for Actys but don't actually fit the car. Other parts get delayed due to COVID supply shortages. But the battery management system, which we needed to determine how and when to charge the batteries, takes the cake. More experienced EV enthusiasts recommended we buy from Daly. Daly, which is a Chinese manufacturer, has an extremely difficult-to-find website. They do have stores on most retailer sites, but most retailer sites didn't let us sort by search parameters like voltage or battery chemistry, so we get a million irrelevant results for BMS that would not work in our car. I finally found a website that listed what we wanted, though amazingly, there was no buy button, just a way to put me in touch with a sales rep. When I emailed the seller, they got anxious about the fact that we were still flexible about our total battery count. I couldn't get them to understand that we would build the system around the BMS, not force the BMS to work with a system we'd already built. Dave, who is fluent in Mandarin, had to take over. I'm not sure what someone would do at this point if they did not speak Mandarin. I guess download Duolingo? We also mistakenly bought a BMS that didn't have Bluetooth at first. We need one with Bluetooth so that it can talk to the display we have. The display is an outdated old Amazon tablet that Mike donated to the project. It isn't just a bell or a whistle. It's the equivalent of a gas meter. If you're in a car, you need to be able to tell if the tank is full.
We've got our BMS box, which is really exciting. It has shipped all the way from Dongguan, which I lived about 40 minutes from there. If we scan this QR code, we can get a box of instant noodles. This is our BMS. We've got our diagram of connection of lithium BMS. It's a good thing I can read some of this. We got strings, which is interesting.
Is that what these are?
Electricity 1 Po. String 13, string, total B minus. We're hoping for a B plus, so we can end up with a B minus.
Oh, this is how we hook up individual batteries. There's another one for...
Oh, that's like a wiring harness. So those are the strings that we're talking about.
This is its temperature sensor.
Understand the structure of our battery pack and find the total negative and total positive poles. Oh, there's an app. For Bluetooth control.
Yes, the tablet will work. There are solutions we could have gotten where, like, we would kind of have to have built this ourselves for, like, $50 or $100 less, and I'm like, it's not that expensive, and this one has an app, and we want the display in our car, and I think there is a point past which our system is too janky. So...
I think we're already there with many of the things. One of our insulated door panels has fallen off because one of the magnets detached from it.
We can pulse contact them and tell them.
Throw this away, but there's something that rattled, yeah. We need that, that's an insulator.
Damn it.
This is really important.
Got another one. That's for
the main. To insulate. Yeah, that's for
positive
each
and negative. Yeah.
I thought installing the BMS app on the tablet would take up 2 seconds of this video. First, I hit problems with the tablet. Mike had deleted his Google Play account, but Google Play kept trying to log him in without a password instead of letting me log into my own account. It would briefly flash a login screen and then navigate away before I could tell it to stop. The web browser version of Google Play pulled up the app's page just fine, but the download button there appears to be purely decorative. Eventually, I realized the tablet was so old that if I opened a lot of apps on it, it would slow it down long enough for me to tap on the username field on the login screen before it attempted to log Mike in. After that, I hit an issue with spyware and software bloat. Apparently, the app needs my location data, but even when I agreed to give the chairman my data, the app and the old tablet just wouldn't play nice. This app is useless, but we may still be able to get our data from the BMS onto a screen in the car. I ordered a $10 part that plugs directly into the BMS and has a simple liquid crystal display that will show the charge of the batteries. It won't do any math to show us what that means for vehicle range, so we may eventually build our own DIY app to get data off this stupid piece of shit. This is what consumers hate about modern devices. Old cars just show you the gas meter. Now you need an app, and the app won't work if you don't have a tablet from the last 2 years, and it will sell your data to marketers. It's a con, and it makes a mission-critical part of a vehicle dependent on software updates while introducing a dozen new points of failure. Cars should not be smart. They should be reliable. Having ordered the plug-in charge monitor, we should finally be good to go. I normally like to end these videos on a happy note like that, but this BMS had one more critical failure.
This is supposed to give me free noodles if I scan this QR code. And I got zero free noodles. Unfortunately, I scanned that QR code and it just gave me like a kind of generic page on Taobao that doesn't really help me at all. We need to ask for a refund on this BMS.
Show your support for mini trucks with a sticker from our store. We also have a GoFundMe. The links are in the description. Join us next time as we fix some mechanical issues with the car and semi-permanently install a load-bearing cottage cheese container.